Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Amir Hussain and you are watching Trick I Know YouTube channel. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you are well and doing good. So in this video, I'm going to do the in-depth review of the Lattepanda 3 Delta. So this review unit is sent by DF Robots. DF Robot is the manufacturer of this Lattepanda single board computer. This is an advanced prototype in the compare of the other single board computers like Raspberry Pi. So I am going to completely demonstrate this product. What is Lattepanda? What you can do with it? What are the benefits of using it? And what great thing this product does? So without wasting any time, let's get into the video. So guys, here is our Lattepanda 3 Delta package. Now let's do a quick unboxing to find out what content are in the box. So here it is, guys. Our box is about to open. So in the first, here we have Lattepanda 3 Delta board itself. Let's put it aside and let me show you the content of the box. So here we have an Asian power cord, a US power cord, some screws and the standoffs. And the next thing is our power adapter to power up the Lattepanda board. So this is kind of a high quality power adapter and the design of the power adapter is also pretty awesome. The output plug we got here is the USB type C plug and here are the description of the input output voltage of this adapter. Now coming back to the board, so it is protected inside a plastic type of case. So let me open it to take out the board. So this is the first look of this board and right after that here we have some Lattepanda stickers. Here's the black one, here's the golden one. Next here we have two antenna module for the Wi-Fi and here is the Lattepanda 3 Delta user manual. Here you will get the overview of the board with the color instructions. So guys, now it's time to take the hardware overview of this board. The first noticeable thing of this board is it has larger cooling area in the comparison of old Lattepanda Alpha. With the bigger fan size, we are not going to face any heating issues. In the front side of the board, we have two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports and one USB 3.2 Gen 2 port. Top side, we have USB Type-C port, audio jack, LAN port and the HDMI port. In the right side, we have system control pins, including audio output, USB output, and RS232 pins. And in the left side, we have gpio pins and Arduino pins. All we have to control the sensors and for coding. And if you look at the top corner of this board, here you will find a DC input socket. So you can run this board with the external battery. One good thing is we have a switch socket here. So we can turn on the board with an external switch if we are making any project like portable PC. We have fan socket as well in case if you are going to use any custom fan. So all those things are in the front side of the board. Now take a look at the back side. In the left side, first here we have a TF plus SIM socket and a EDP display socket and a touch panel socket. In the bottom side, we have M.2 B key socket for 4G 5G module and a M.2 M key socket for external graphic card and for NVMe SSDs. And here is an inbuilt card for Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5.2. Our inbuilt 64GB memory is also visible from here. So in these ways, this board is expandable. Now take a look on the specifications. So guys, our Lattepanda 3 Delta is an advanced prototype single board computer and it comes with Intel 11th Gen Celeron N5105 processor. It's a 4 core processor with the speed of up to 2.9 GHz. The internal graphics is Intel UHD graphics with the speed of up to 800 MHz. The RAM memory is LPDDR4 8GB RAM with the speed of 2933 MHz. This board also comes with the inbuilt eMMC storage of 64GB. to install any light operating systems. Moreover, it has dual band Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi 6 with the both speed of 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. We have Bluetooth 5.2 facility also in this board, and also we have built-in TPM 2.0 on this board. So there is not any problem installing Windows 11, and you can install Windows 10 and Linux as well. So with all these functionalities, this board is completely hackable and you can make multiple projects with it by adding communication protocols like RS-232 or RS-485 etc. You can make robots or a fancy PC, or maybe you can make a powerful portable PC as well. And if you are a programmer, you can enjoy Python with an incredible fast speed. You can complete your programming journey in a smarter way. So this is a complete package in a single board, so you can complete your desired projects. Now let me show you guys how to set it up. The setup is very easy and simple. Let's start with the standoffs. So these are the plastic standoffs and screws provided in the box. If you don't have any case, you can start by applying these. So once you did it, it will look like this. For the storage and operating system, the board has already an inbuilt 64GB eMMC card, but you can also add a M.2 SSD to install another operating system. Here is my Samsung EVO Plus 1TB SSD, and I am going to install Windows 11 on it to test how it performs. Here are the Bluetooth and Wi-Fi antennas. Let's put them on the board too. Just plug them into the socket. Use the official Lattepanda 7-inch EDP touch display. You can check the screen video in my channel. In this video, I am going to use my 27-inch 4K monitor. This is a USB Type-C monitor, so it can be beneficial for the power delivery to the Lattepanda board. For the interface, you can use any regular wired or wireless keyboard and mouse. In this video, I am going to use a mini keyboard that is also sent by the DF Robot. This is a quality keyboard by DF Robot. I will leave a link for this product in the video description. So here is the wireless keyboard dongle ins, HDMI cable from the monitor, and Type-C power supply from the power adapter. So guys, our Lattepanda 3 Delta is all set up. Now it's time to turn it on. So guys, now I'm going to turn on the switch of the Lattepanda board. Here it is. This is the first boot, and the board comes with a pre-installed Windows 10 operating system on it in the 64GB eMMC memory. Here it boots up with it. So let's check the speed guys. Everything is appearing very fast. Now I'm going to connect the 5G Wi-Fi, the Wi-Fi 6. And here the Wi-Fi network is connected. Now it's time to check out the browser. So here is the Edge browser initializing, cause it's opened for the first time. Here guys, the Edge browser is opened finally. Now I'm going to open up the YouTube to check out some browsing experience. Here I am looking for a 4K video. The search results are incredibly fast. The system is running very well guys. Really, it's the fastest Lattepanda single board computer yet. Here is the 4K video running with the built-in eMMC memory. Now I am going to perform a crystal disk mark test on the eMMC memory. And here are the final results. The eMMC memory is giving the read speed of 299 and the write speed of 155 Mbps. Now guys, I am going to check out the Windows 11 performance on this board, which I installed in my M.2 SSD. To boot from the SSD, all you have to do, just press F7 to open the boot menu of the Lattepanda 3 Delta while starting, and here you can select your SSD or the eMMC memory from here. To make the SSD default, just enter the BIOS setup and go to the boot tab, and in the boot option 1, here you have to select the SSD. Once you do that, now go to the save and exit and save the settings. So this way you can dual boot your Lattepanda with the different operating systems. So guys, now you can see this board is running Windows 11 itself. Everything is running very fine and good. Now I'm going to perform a crystal disk mark test on this SSD. Let's see what are the results. Here are the results guys, and this SSD is performing 1743 Mbps read and 1476 write speed. Now guys, let's check the 4K performance of this board with the SSD. The performance is already good with the eMMC memory, but with the better read-write speed, you may see some boost in the frames. So here is the 4K video guys, running at 2160p. Let me turn on the Nerd 4 stats so you can see the statics. And as you can see, the performance is great in the comparison of other single board computers like Raspberry Pi, Orange Pi, etc. So that was the 4K test guys. You can also play some of the old games here, or you can emulate PS games as well. To keep the video short, I am showing two old most played games. Here is the GTA San Andreas with the HD resolution and in high quality. And here is NFS Most Wanted, the most played old game. So guys, there are lots of things you can do with this Lattepanda 3 Delta. This is a $279 board in 2023. You can directly buy this board from DF Robot. Check the product link in the video description. The official Titan case and other accessories are also available in the site. So guys, that was my review on the Lattepanda 3 Delta. Hope you enjoyed this review. If you really enjoyed this video, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe my channel for more project like this. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. Share this video with your friends and families. Thanks a lot for watching guys. See you in my next video.